All right, on. On. Let's see. Hang on. All right. The red light's on for this one. Red light. How about you?
I'm good to go.
We're gonna do a little intro or so.
I'm gonna do my little intro right here. Hello, everybody out there in YouTube land, and to you too, and to the camera. See my hand. Okay. I'm amateur artist Mark D. Chandler, once again from Manland, and today we have a special guest and a special video. Ranger Cookie has decided to join me again on this illustrious day, the day of Wednesday. What is it, September
29th?
Yeah,
I think so. 28th.
28th! I'm a day ahead of myself. And year 2016. The reason I'm putting the date in here is because, well, you never know. I'm rambling. Anyway, today is a cooking video. We're going to actually do some cooking.
I'm starving.
Now, we come out here to the picnic table. Ranger wanted me to meet him out there at the one of the parks and everything. I said, man, that's fantastic. I don't have time. I got to go to work tomorrow. But we decided we were going to do a little cooking video. And since we're here at the apartments again and we're using this picnic table, well, they kind of frowned on the idea that, well, we were actually going to build a wooden fire right here on top of the picnic table and cook this thing old school, you know what I'm saying? But they kind of frown on that kind of stuff. So we're kind of going back to the Coleman propane container and burner on top. And I don't know what to call the burner. It's on the tag there somewhere. But anyway, that's immaterial, you know? You get the stuff at Walmart, right?
Wally World!
That's right. We're cooking on this dude right here, and we're going to get her going. So, Cookie, what we cooking today?
We're gonna cook all kinds of big stuff. We're gonna cook chicken. We got chicken.
Chicken?
Chicken. We got cheeseburger dinner from the cable guy. Show him, man.
We're gonna cook up some Larry the Cable Guy. That's right. You know why? Because we can.
Look, cable guy. There you go. And we're gonna also be cooking. Where's the beef?
Oops.
Where's the beef?
Man, we just went 30 miles out here in the front yard and we got the ground beef.
I'm starving. Go get it.
That's a long hike back. Okay. Don't go away.
Cut!
Show the hell did it in the picture. And what else did he need?
You got butter, didn't you? We got salt and pepper, we got two spoons, we got two plates. Just meat the beef. Ow. Get close. Let's see what this thing's seeing.
It's more pointed this way. It needs to be that. There you go.
It's really close where I want it. I can see you, the whole table, and it's recording. Okay, that's recording. Record. Where's the beef? Where's the beef at? Will somebody give me some beef? Now, beef. Today we need some beef. A fire start, some type of thing to start fire with. 2 cups of water, sweet tea, Mr. Cable Guy, hamburger dinner,
and a yellow school bus.
Let's make the noises. 2 chopsticks, chum dai, 1 grill that we're not gonna use, Manland's drink for the day.
My purple stuff.
Some vegetable air, another drink for Mr. Mullen.
An unopened can of purple.
2 green bowls to eat the grubbing. Salt and pepper. A jar of mayonnaise.
Yeah, pretend that's the seal stuff that don't have to be refrigerated.
Some cheesy stuff that goes on cheese stuff.
That don't have to be refrigerated.
Cheesy part makes it cheesy. And we got a Stanley, no.
That's the Stanley Adventure Prep and Cook Set Cook Pot.
We have garlic, potato chip thingy things.
Potatoes au gratin.
And we also have some chicken, all breasts. And
breast,
one,
no, thigh.
Thigh. Thigh. And the last thing on our day is the...
the big ass cook pot. Miles and Reed.
All right, let's get cooking. First, we need to...
turn gas on.
How are we going to light it?
Don't you have your ferro rod?
It's in a bag somewhere.
Okay, I got my emergency standby.
The best,
always the big lighter.
The best item you can find in a bushcrafting survival situation. All right, wait a minute. Oh, go cook the beet. It burns! Damn!
Baby bird.
Okay. All right, we need...
You do not put the pot on the bottom first. First, you place the ground beef in the container. In the container, not over the fire. Bad cookie.
You yell at me, Mama.
It would. It would have been pretty daggum cool if that would have worked.
Okay. I guess we got to turn this down. We'll burn our meat.
We want it real low. Real low. You want a really low flame. Remember, your cook pots are not as thick as the ones you use at home.
I hear it cooking already. Now we hear our...
And one thing you never ever do not walk away from your cooking. That's very important. Don't do it. Stay there and watch it. Don't go away.
Do we need some oil in here?
Nope.
What?
Pure hamburger. It makes its own oil.
I don't burn my pot.
Of course not. If it's really low, it won't.
Now, all the damaged things you get this big tall thing. What?
I've got the little small ones, but they're too expensive, so I don't use them. I like cheap stuff.
You sons of bitches! You! Think about this, folks. When you are making a video, we got to move all this stuff from 100 miles to get to that location. Then we have to think about what we're going to say and how we're going to say it, even though we all unscripted. Because unscripted is better. Believe it or not, that's a good comedy. Because you don't know what the other sucker is going to say.
That's right.
So, when you go make a video, just come up with your own, what's in your heart. But no, stick to the plan. Our plan is cooking, so stick to it, right?
That's right. It's wide open plan, too. I like that. It's smelling good already.
I don't see that.
It's brown good. I can't see.
Nope, it's not. I'm trying to keep it turned so it won't burn the pit.
It won't burn. Once it's covered at the bottom, it ain't going to burn. It might put that crust on the bottom, but it ain't burning. It's the good num-nums. There's Ranger Cookie's camera right over there. And he's got one hanging up in the tree to get the upside down look directly into the cook pot. Look at that, man. Looks like the moon rover landed in the tree upside down. Didn't quite make it to the moon. Came right back down.
Now, I know some of you guys cannot take a long video because we got small peanuts because we're YouTubers.
That's right. Warning, this is going to be a long one.
So, but if you keep talking through your videos when you're doing stuff and teaching or showing something about something or just talking, for example, I'm talking about making videos and... making videos are pretty hard. Look at all the stuff we had to bring down. This is hard work. I might as well just go work and get paid for it.
That's why I brought my backpack right there. It's on four wheels and it moves on its own.
I thought it was on two.
No, mine's on four.
You sure? Four. I thought it was your wife.
That too. That's the portable backpack.
Oh yeah, for that. So as you keep talking through your videos, your subscribers won't get bored of your, just sitting here doing this. I mean, if you're talking through your videos, and this is a little shot off of Glock 17. So if you're watching, do some talking in your videos. Because when you're talking in your videos, and don't be kind of boring, because people don't like that unless you're doing good quality videos.
That reminds me, I'd like to give a good old-fashioned USD approved shout out to Shiny Knife out there, Mr. Shiny Knife. That happened to be a good buddy of mine. Y'all go check it out, boys. You know where to find that link. It's gonna be in that description box below. Let's get back to the cooking. I'm tired of advertising.
Check my bait, sure I got in me, I'm in view. So
you are in view.
Okay, good. That'll be a cut. Action. So when you're making a video, make sure you enjoy the video you're making. Because for example, when I first started, I'm like, what kind of videos I want to make? Okay, I like survival. Me and my friend, basically, my channel is all about my friend passing away. That's what started me in my channel, because I want to show you what I know before I go on. I'm a teacher. Everybody who's doing YouTube channel, bushcrafting, those are teachers. They're teaching what they know. Some of them think they know more than everybody. I try not to do that. I try not to say, oh, I know more. No, I do not know more. I'm an amateur.
So what do you know?
What? Why I show you?
Especially when we dig in and eat.
It's whatever I show you is, I think outside the little pink box I have. I have that little pink box. Y'all cook chicken, y'all cook it this way. Well, I cook chicken. You want more. You will kill for more. I'll kill you for more.
I have to say, Cookie come over and cooked for us several times before. He's a mighty good cook. But he didn't tell me that he was a professional cook. We didn't find out until one of them live streams. there it is. It's green. Can't find it. It's camouflage. He lost his fire.
I just turned it up a little bit more and I went the wrong way. I can't read. All right, back to the subject. Let's not get off subject.
What was the subject?
The subject was me making my YouTube channel.
Oh.
Because my friend passed away and he had a lot more knowledge than me, and he's a little bit more, he got brains because he don't have dyslexia. Dyslexia affects my ability of everything sometimes. Sometimes it kicks in more, sometimes it don't kick in. So now you're making a YouTube channel. So what you gonna call it? Are you gonna be a blogger? You gonna be a gamer? You're going to be a shooter. Or you're going to be a bushcrafting show. You got so many ways to make videos on YouTube. So you have to ask yourself, are you going to create a character? I created a couple of characters. One's Ranger Cookie. And my other characters, like Jerry.
Hello, daddy.
That's Jerry, my little furball friend, sits on my shoulder. He's invisible, come from my planet.
I didn't see nobody sitting on your shoulder.
And he's invisible. Damn you, boy. Then we got Larry. He's in the car right now.
Ranger Cookie. Larry's here.
All right, I'll get you later, Larry. Then I carried another character named Pickles. Mr. Pickles.
Oh, yeah. I love YouTubers.
You like to eat YouTubers, huh?
Yeah.
So I carried a couple of characters in my show. So to keep you entertained. And another thing, keep your commentary different. Change it up. Don't do the same video over and over and over, because people are going to get bored. Do something different in your video. If you never talk, talk. If you never show yourself, well, there's a lot of people who don't show themselves, and they do. I like, Mr. AK-47. I just say the bear guy. Mr. Bear. I love Mr. Bear.
I believe it's Mr. Full Auto AK-47.
Full Auto AK-47. Mr. Bear.
And believe me, it took me a year to learn it.
I love his videos. It's been a while since I've been over there. And you know what, man? I get home, I'm going to watch a couple of his videos and catch up. And yes, I know most YouTubers got a fan base. They love certain people and they watch their videos to the end of the world. So my recommend, I like to binge watch videos. So if you make a playlist of all your videos, and I'll enjoy your show, enjoy your channel, I'll watch almost every one of them. Like Papa Texas. This is Papa Texas. And this is Papa cooking. Oh, look, it's Ranger cooking. Ranger cooking at the cookie show. So that's a little shout out for you, Mr. Papa Texas, Mr. Papa cooking. All right, this is done. What you think?
All right. Let me eyeball it here. Let's see. Ooh, look at
you. Little bit of red.
That's firing right there.
All right, let's take it down. So we're going to...
Come here, bag.
So now we're going to cook. We need 2 cups of water. Looks like more than a cup of water.
I believe that is way more than a cup.
Yeah, we got a little measurement thing on the side, which don't make sense because it's all millimeter and ounces.
Oh, no. Let's see here.
Then where you show me cup. All ounces right. And millimeter.
That's ounces?
Yeah.
Well, 8 ounces is a cup. You got 16 ounces right there, which is where you're at, right about there.
That's what we need.
Perfect. Two cups, 16 ounces.
Nothing.
Send the boy to school, and what does he learn?
Chicken.
Eat the chicken.
Chicken!
Now, Larry the Cable Guy is going into the pot. We got some, some kind of dry, dehydrated macaroni. Oh, listen to that wonderful sound. Oh, you did it backwards. That's supposed to go in the big pot.
You're supposed to cook a macaroni thingy.
Yeah. We're putting the burger and stuff into the macaroni thing.
Yeah, but you gotta pre-cook the macaroni.
Oh, no.
What was supposed to cook?
You did not read the directions.
No.
That's all right. Just take what you got in that pot and pour it into your big one.
Yeah, there we go. Is it childproof? Is this thing childproof?
It's not childproof. It's cookie proof. Hold on, I got
knife. See, that's one thing we didn't bring, a knife.
I've always got a knife. The Rough Rider. From Mad Mal's bushcrafting experience. I can't say bushcrafting, it's bushcraft experience. But it sounds cooler, Mal, when you say Mad Mal's bushcrafting experience.
Ah, back to the subject.
For some reason, I'm an expert on naming channels.
And keep your contact different every video you make. Try to make it different. Don't put the same contact out every time. Because believe it or not, your channel will get boring. I'm not just talking about you, Glock, so don't get that. I'm talking about all channels that put out the same contact. Put something different. I enjoy that cleaning video.
What cleaning video?
It was on Glock 17. He did a cleaning video on his Glock because it jammed. And I left a comment on his channel saying he the bad guy got you that day. And he went home and cleaned it.
Oh, that served in the way. Don't it?
All right, what were we supposed to be?
The sun sets, gently sets over the Ranger's white shoulder.
So, oh yeah, we're supposed to clean our tots. That's what we're supposed to clean our tots.
That's why I wanted to put that next one, the big one. And use the graton.
I need one bottle. I got it.
One bottle? Okay.
Okay, we messed up, so we're going to take this and put it in this pot here for now. And maybe let it simmer, maybe. We need water real quick before we burn our pot.
Yep. Never set a pot directly on the fire. Is that 2 cups?
That's a whole bottle.
All right, and what does the package say? 2 cups?
This one says,
I don't remember.
2.5. Two and a half.
That'll work. We're going to add some mayonnaise to it.
I need a knife again.
Another improvised moment here. Rough Rider to the rescue.
Whee! take your blade and go like a switchblade. People get scared of you. Oh, he gets a switchblade. Oh, I'm gonna die.
Just fling your spoon, man. Fling your spoon.
Are we supposed to put this in here now?
No, not yet. That is the cheese, and then we mix that up real good.
We improvise milk for mayonnaise. Never heard of it.
Milk, mayonnaise. Mayonnaise is a good milk substitute, a good egg substitute, a good oil substitute. It's a good for everything substitute. And it's really good on bologna sandwiches.
All right, back to the YouTube content. So change up your content every time you make a video. For example, I used to watch this gamer. I enjoyed his videos. But after a while, listening to the same tune in the beginning of his video, of his intro, made me turn away from him. Dum da 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 dip da da. Every video. Dum dum da 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 da. Think about it. In your head, every time you watch this man's video. I watched that. What are you doing behind me? There you go.
It was kind of a catchy tune.
So every video, and certain people, I hate to say this, but certain people don't like the same thing over and over. It bothers the hell out of them. Like me, I have dyslexia and some other things with bells. I hate ding dings, bells.
Hey man, is this a cooking video or a rant?
It's a rant and a cooking video. That way,
y'all,
I won't be
it all in this one video.
Let's just think about it. If I was just cooking, this is what I'd be doing. All right, you stir the thing. Okay, we stir the thing. But if I rant, you'd probably watch the whole video because I'm ranting. And I'm teaching you something about YouTube channels.
Hey, while we're ranting, I like to rant a little bit too.
There you go.
You know, there's a no good low down scuzz bucket that I just really hate. He's got the initials of RK, and he's got this YouTube channel, and now I'm starting to talk just like him. He's really annoying.
I do get annoying, but that's the fun part. So when you watch my intros, it's different every time.
Cookie.
What's up?
You're always number one in my book.
Hey, I got one for you, baby.
Hey, I got the box too. Have to do it from this side. The bicentennial. Da 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 da. What does it mean? I can't say we're on YouTube.
You know it just means.
That's right.
Hey, ASS.
Right, we'll leave it at that.
So, having a good contact.
We sure shall.
Now, earlier, there's some people who don't like to show their face. Hey, I don't mind you doing that, as long as you got good content. There's a couple of people like that. AK-47 does it, you do it. But that's fine, you want to be private. I don't mind that. He's not private.
I'm Glove Man.
Da, 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 da. See, now that made this video so much more interesting to watch from the beginning to end, because this guy's ranting about his channel and about people and blah, 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 but I try not to put drama in my videos. There's drama videos you can watch. You can go Drama Alert, which I never even watched one of them. I don't watch drama or what you call it, blogging videos.
I call it soap operas.
Yeah, basically. But if you are a subscriber and you, some people do have good content about certain things, you might as well say Texas Papa. Papa Texas is a blogger, but he cooks.
Right, I'm a blogger. Got some good cooking too.
Ooh. Yeah, and we're all bloggers in a way. I'm blogging and cooking. So there's bloggers that does nothing but bloggers. Then they got people who watch videos of other people, reaction videos. Then they got people that talk bad about other people, which gets thousands of views.
For some reason.
Yeah, it's weird. Talk bad about somebody, you get views. And you get thumbs down too.
Isn't there enough hate in the world?
He got plenty of hate in the world.
That's why Man Land does his channel his style. He likes to bring a smile upon the faces of the viewers.
That's what they say about my channel. You ever talk to a horsey? You need to go to my blooper video and watch me talk to horsies. Or talking to bugs, or playing with bugs, or fun with bugs. Go watch that video. You ever watch that video, fun with bugs?
I have.
Did you enjoy
me? I remember the bug that landed on that clothesline, I believe it was.
Big dragonfly.
Yeah. And the thing stood there. It didn't run.
I just say, what do you want? Just clean his eyes. Then I talked to some spiders. It was a woofing spider.
I don't remember the spider.
Yeah, right behind us. Go check it out. You know what to do.
I just walk into them and eat them.
And they're a little crunchy, the kind you get.
Yeah, it wasn't really, I really didn't want to, but it just happened that way.
Let's take a look over here and see if this is cooking.
Nope, that's just sitting.
Yep, it's sitting. So the plan was to cook our beef, cook our noodles. We were supposed to cook this first, because I forgot what we were supposed to cook first.
Yeah, we cooked that one there first that you got on now.
Yeah, it's supposed
to. And we set it to the side.
Set it to the side, let it juice up.
Let it congeal. And then we cooked that one.
And put the chicken in.
And chicken added later.
Then we throw it all together in one big goob gobblish and stir it and make spider goulash.
That's right.
Alright, what else you can learn by making YouTube channels? I made a character. Some people have characters, some people don't. I like a character. I created many characters. I got 3 channels. Only some of y'all know about it. That's right, I got 3 channels, and I don't talk about the first one. The first one's private. Well, not private, but it's out there.
Oh no, did the wind blow it out?
No, it's still lit.
Blow back, it'll yeah. Back up in a minute.
It's still lit.
There you go.
So I put replicas of my first channel all through my videos. You just have to find them. I got so many open giveaways that no one notices because I tell y'all I got codes and special hidden words and stuff like that. If you find them, you'll get a prize. So far, no one even forgot about it. So especially my new subscribers, they don't go to old videos. That's what I don't get. Here's a question. Why don't you go to some of YouTubers' old videos? Maybe they have something that might help you in some way. But I notice only people say, well, I'm new. I'm only going to watch your new videos. But there's so much good content in the back. So I learned over time just to remake my videos, but just a different way. So you might see the same content, but a different way of doing it. Damn rascals, making all kinds of noises.
What did you?
Mama bear! You want to take some of this?
I think you take some of this to the trash can. To the trash can, Batman.
Alright, I guess I'm going to do a cutscene here because all the evil babies or rascals are making noises. Yeah, I just did a cut.
Let's cut and stand by.
Let's see, it's a top button. Yeah, it always changed the view. like we was planning on. All right. We got bubbling stuff in the pot.
Molten lava of the cheese. Another shout out to Cheesehead Chris.
Cheesy! It makes it cheesy here.
Yeah, I threw the box away, didn't I? No, I didn't.
Here, it's right here.
It's triple cheese.
For
right
Cheesehead.
There. Triple cheesy for Cheesehead Chris.
There you go, Chris. I got a shout out for you, my triple cheese.
Oh, you show it there? Triple cheese. Triple cheese.
Goodness. Triple cheese.
As Larry says, gotta try it.
Alright.
And today, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to test the potatoes to make sure that they are mushy. It's a hot, hot, hot.
It just came out of a pot, you retard.
Who hand it to me?
Alright, I think it's thick enough. What you think?
Potatoes need to cook a little longer.
All right, we'll go cook a little longer. How about we turn it down a little bit?
They're still raw, yeah. But they're almost there. Not many people in the world like to eat a raw potato, and I love them. You ever eat a potato raw?
Yeah.
My wife looked at me like I'd lost my mind.
Just don't eat red beans raw. You will have diarrhea. It's poisonous.
Well, that could be a good thing if you need to go.
Yeah, but you don't want to do that when you're middle of the woods. So that's always good. Take diarrhea pills when you go in the woods.
That's a good point there. I like that. That's real expert advice.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Consider the source of who it came from.
There you go.
That ain't fair. He took a drink. I got to do the same thing. Except I'm not going to spill my tea on me.
Shut up. I'll beat you next time.
I almost did. Oh, while we've got it in frame, I'd like to talk about the wooden spoons that Cookie is using there. That right there happens to be the spoon that Donnie Pavolini of Donnie Pavolini Outdoors gave me. And we've got the mini-me spoon given to me by Jason of the Parker Ridges. So this right here is a great big old shout out to the Wooden Spoon Club, created and invented by none other than Cole Craven Bushcraft.
Whee!
Man, I love the club, and I hope this allows me to get a temporary foot into the club, because I'm of the, I guess, the frame of mind. You're not really a member unless you carve your own spoon.
Yes.
That's kind of what I think. But hey, if this gets me in, fine and dandy. If not, I'll carve my own, which I plan on doing at the VU too.
That'd be kind of cool. And look, if y'all going to the VU too, and you're watching Manland on my channel, this year I'm going to ask y'all to make an arrowhead for my sentimental value collection. If you don't know what that is, go check out my video, Sentimental Value.
Is this a wooden arrowhead or a real arrowhead?
A wooden arrowhead.
Okay, I can do that.
So if you have time to carve you one before you get to the VU, so you don't have to carve it when you get there, go ahead and get your carving. Carve your arrowhead the way you like it and put your initials on it. And when you see me, hand it to me. Because that's going to be sentimental value. And I'm going to do this every year and change it up every year.
Last year you had
the stakes.
Tent stakes.
Tent stakes.
Yep, that was cool, man. Almost made me cry. I said almost. It really didn't, but it almost did.
I bet you the video almost made you cry.
It did. Y'all need to check that out. That link to that particular video will, of course, be in the description box below. No. We need to come up with an abbreviation for that. Check the link below.
All right, what you think? Is it thick enough?
Let's try another taste tester. Damn, it's still hot. It's close. I mean, it's right on the verge.
Well, it should take 15 minutes. That's a lot of fuel.
Well, remember, we're cooking on low heat.
The lighter, come on, hurry up, cooking.
It mysteriously appeared.
Oh, it is on. One thing about these blue flames, and you got the sun on it, you don't know if it's on or not. So you go put your hand on it. Sad! Give it a bubble! Roy!
I think this was the instance where he was trying to use the stove to light the lighter. You always said you wanted to be different.
Well, that's one way of doing it. Oh yeah, by the way, that little pink box. I try to think out of the box. I don't want to put the same type of contact that somebody else already put out.
Oh wait, what I'm thinking. Let's get this in frame. Where's the frame? I can't see.
Okay, right here.
In case y'all are wondering, we made a discovery. The Stanley Adventure Prep and Cook Set lid, yes, it fits perfectly. On the pause and read. I can't pronounce that word.
I can't read.
O-G-G-I. It's a
aircraft container, stainless steel, 18-8 stainless steel aircraft container.
Yes, there we go. It's a.
They can read.
It's some kind of stainless steel airtight canister. I don't know where it got it from, but it's cool as all get out.
Pay $5 for it. How much? $5?
You know what I want?
What you want?
I want one like that.
Might have to go online because I thought this had a William Army shirt surplus stores.
Don't worry, I'm going to do some Google search.
It's lightweight.
What happened?
I don't know. That just scared the hell out of me.
It's done that to me too before. I don't know what's going on. Man, the food's coming back to get us.
All right, I think that's enough for me.
I think that's done. We can set that to the side.
Now we're going to finish cooking our neuters.
Larry the Cable Guy's specialty, the triple cheese cheeseburger dinner. In other words, it's just like a hamburger helper meal. Now, if you could imagine, we use fresh ground beef in this, correct, Mr. Cookie?
Correct.
But they could have used actual rocks. No, not real rocks. What they call gravel, which is actually dehydrated ground beef, or more precisely, a chuck. And it's dehydrated, and you rehydrate it while you're on the trail. I know, I get that same feeling when I think about something like that. But it works, hey, it does its trick. And I've not actually done that yet. I needs to do it. I mean, I'm the old-fashioned school. I buy fresh stuff.
I got a question for you, YouTubers. I gave my friend Mark D. Chandler, average Mark D. Chandler.
Yeah, I'm an average.
A dehydrator.
Yes.
So if you have any recipes for Mr. Mark D. Chandler, please put it down below.
That would be excellent. I toast to that. Woo! The power of the dehydrator. Or is that power of the Power Rangers? I forgot.
It's something like that. Should we add salt and pepper or just let it go?
I'll let it cook for now.
Yeah, we can add it to our own meal. That way we can have...
Well, I mean, I add it in there when it's cooking, but I don't do it toward the very... until it gets toward the end of the cooking.
Oh, this thing's not even burling. It got water in it, so it's not going to burn like this.
I'm killing this one for now.
Yeah, I'm ready to do the same.
I don't run out of things to think of.
Yeah, I know.
They don't realize how close it is. That camera's still on. You know, them folks that sit there, and I'm going to do this in exclusive on Cookie's channel. Them folks that like to comment on your channel and, you know, you go and check out their stuff and they ain't got no content, how dare them. I mean, they don't know what they're doing. What gives them the right to make any kind of suggestions or comments when they don't have none of their stuff on their own channel? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Ticks me off, I tell you. It's not the fact they want to leave comments. That's cool. But when they try to give you advice and they act like, professional buttholes.
Didn't you just have one?
Instead of complaining, make your own video and prove that we're wrong, man. You know, just do it. You don't do it. You know why? I don't know why.
Yo, chicken.
Yep. We're finna cook you.
All right.
Are you back?
Well, that one's on.
Okay. Keep on going.
Yeah. That one's off, huh?
That one's off.
Okay. So, making a channel is freaking hard. So right now I'm kind of running out of options and stuff, but the only thing I could probably do is right now is talk about my channel a little bit more. I created a character. His name is Ranger Kookie. My nickname was Kookie in the beginning with, because everybody thought I was Kookie because of my dyslexia and the way I speak.
But you are Kookie.
Yeah, I am Kookie. You even said that. You call me crazy kooky on your...
Did I call you crazy?
Crazy kooky.
With a K?
Yeah, crazy.
K, crazy kooky.
Yep, he called me crazy kooky one time.
I could not figure out your name.
Crazy kooky.
When I was talking, I couldn't remember.
He was drunk,
too.
He was drunk. That crazy kooky, I never... He was like a rude comment. You know what I did? I just say, oh, well, he's freaking drunk. I'm not going to say
I think that's what... And this is racist now, hold on. You ought to start a KKK response channel. That is Crazy Cookies Comments.
11-11-11. 33. So I made a character named Ranger Kooky. Well, my first character was blah, 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 blah. Then my...
Really? Blah, 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 blah,
yep,
blah,
yep.
Blah.
Type it up, blah, 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 and you'll find me.
Okay.
Then, when I first started, it was like, I didn't know what to say. I was dumbfounded.
I'll get it. Keep on talking.
I was dumbfounded. Didn't know what to say. But later on, I start saying such and such and such. Like I do today, like Ranger Kooky.
I saved it. It's for aliens. You always keep your aluminum foil.
Thank you. You never know when doom government's trying to eat your brains. So I made a character named Ranger Kooky. He's a bushcrafter. Plus, my friend was a bushcrafter, so I try to show you what I'd learned over time. And
can't we give the name of your friend?
Angel Bajuri.
That's right. We never actually shouted him out. So we'd like to give a 121 and Ranger Kooky salute to Andrew McCurry.
Majuri,
excuse me. To Andrew Majuri, we salute you, no matter where you're at.
Thank you.
You know what? I'm just saddened that I never actually got the opportunity to actually meet him.
And believe it or not, I told this to Manland one time. If my friend probably never died, I probably never started a YouTube channel. But I thought about it, but he didn't want to be on YouTube. But I probably never met you guys if I never started a YouTube channel.
Huh.
The first person I ever met online of a YouTuber was Donnie Paolini. That's Bonnie right. Paolini Outdoors.
I remember that video.
And the reason I found where I found him, because his video was everyday carry video, and he went to the POW camp. I took some pictures there one time. And I'm like, damn, he's right there in Mississippi. I want to get in touch with this. Donnie, I mean, he got in touch with me first. He added me, he commented me. It was really Chris in the Woods was the first guy. Then this Gear Sanctuary, then Donnie Paolini, then somebody else, some other names. I keep telling y'all people, names are like cars. Throw them up, grab them. Then Mr. Manland got on because Donnie Paolini.
Mm-hmm.
Then later on,
that's
like the
power of shout outs. You don't get to meet people unless you're actually given a few shout outs. And you know, most, and I'm not ranting here, but most well-known channels that have a lot of viewers, or subscriptions I should say, very rarely give a shout out.
Yeah. Y'all only think about themselves because, well, maybe I had to think for them why they do it. Because maybe they don't have time. Maybe they don't have time to read your description.
That would be the number one thing. I mean, that's happening to me, so I'll give them that.
I mean, let's think about all the flaws, why they don't do it, or why they don't comment back at you, or make a video about you.
That man's just plain rude, man. Just plain rude.
But believe it or not, I got a creation video, and it went around. It went to some big people, too. It went out to Big Monkey 1.
Really Big Monkey 1.
Oh, really Big
Monkey 1. Really Big Monkey 1.
And
Dave
Pearson. And I told him about it, and he subbed to me. I thought
Dave's a good guy. I love Dave.
Dave, yep. So a little shout out for Dave, even though he has billions of subscribers and billions of views. It's weird how somebody can put good content and have thousands of views, even an hour long, and we have to put 10-minute videos out.
You know what, man? There's one channel out there that's got like over a billion subscribers. He never comments to my channel. And of course, again, it goes to that RK letter. I just don't understand why he doesn't take the time to talk to me.
I got a knife here, buddy.
Manland stabbed by his own knife.
I got a knife here.
The initials RK. details at 5.
And look, we have the little rascals today.
Hey, I'm not
a rascal. What y'all do? You're not a rascal.
Hey, why you put this in there?
Alright, so we're going to ask you a question. Why you're not a rascal? Because.
You know what?
Wait a minute. You don't even know who the little rascals are.
I
do. Where are they?
The little rascals?
No, you're not talking about the cartoon, The Little Rascals. We talk about Rascalers. What's it called, The Little Rascals?
The Little Rascals.
Yeah.
Movie.
Yeah, it was a black in the day. They had a black and white. That's probably what's wrong with him. He got the wrong rascals.
Ah, see, I didn't know there was a cartoon about that.
Yeah.
The movie.
How your hand ain't burnt?
What, now you camera shot? You wasn't the other day.
Yeah, you got it like this. You got it. It's a cartoon about it, too.
All right, in a few seconds, we're going to ask y'all to move away because we're in camera or in video.
Huh?
So maybe that's what's going on. If you want me to talk about it.
Getting food for.
Yeah. That's probably what's going on. But
I'm glad you found that still.
We can cut that later. Mm-hmm. Alright, let's see. Back to subject. You can probably cut that whole thing out if you want.
What were we talking about?
We was just talking about videos and subs. Alright, action.
News at 5. That's what it was. News at 5.
Alright, yeah, a lot of people. What you think about this? Alright, let's check out. Look at. Oh, yeah, we have to look for the noodles. I don't think we centigrated them.
Let's see here. Ooh, them looking good. Oh, they are tender. Yes, they are.
All right, I guess we got this. This is done. All right, we're supposed to put the chicken in, right?
Right, as chicken.
Wait a minute, we're supposed to cook this. Oh, that's
no, cooked. That's already cooked.
Just all right, now we're going to take the spoon out. Put it over here. I'm going to add the chicken and get it hot. Kill the bacteria that grew.
You mean chicken's got bacteria in it?
If you let it sit around for a while.
But that just don't sound safe, man. It sounds unethical.
Well, that's why you gotta cook it.
Poor chicken. He wasn't bothering nobody until somebody decided to kill him. I guess that's why he's got that vegetable thing going on. You eat me now and I'll kill you. I got bacteria.
Selling me Miller.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Right there. Simon Tellers.
All right.
Are you stirring or are you poking?
I'm poking it. I was trying to get the meat to the bottom so it's all through the thing. Hey, you're talking to a non-professional cook.
Looks like you were making butter there for a minute. He was turning away.
That's what I tell the people at work. I'm a non-professional doing professional work. Because if you go around and bragging about yourself, you're better than everybody. Guess what? Every time I talk about somebody or some, you think I'm talking about you. No, I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about them. So don't give me this because I'm talking about them.
Well, them happens to be you.
Yeah, no.
But not you, them.
Yeah.
The other them or the other you.
All right, let's let this settle. Let's turn it down. Let this bubble. Now, let's finish talking about YouTube. So you have to also, when you're making videos and being a YouTube channel, you have to take negative comments too. Negative attitudes with others.
I don't like them negative comments.
But you gotta take them.
But I don't want to.
Well, you can delete them.
But I don't want to do that either. I want people to see them comments and come to my rescue.
That's true.
But we don't want to feed the troll.
Yep.
Unfortunately.
Learn a lesson. If you got a troll. See, I was... Oh, yeah. Phyllis... What's her name?
Mookie.
Yeah, Phyllis Mookie. I'm going to do a new thing about that. I suppose I've done it. About the troll forest. Some of us YouTubers cannot carve a troll.
Like me.
So I'm going to find a way of saying... Draw a picture on something and send it to me or something. I don't know. All right, here you go. Here's a question to YouTubers. I want to build a troll forest. And I asked my subscribers to carve a troll and send it to me, and I was going to put it in a forest. It could be in the park, it could be in my woods, it could be at my camp. And so far, only my friend Phyllis McMurray, whatever her name, Mookie, sent one troll. I was so happy when I got that troll. Oh, you can watch that video. It's called Mail Time for My Subs, I think. But I enjoy that. So what can we do to make some type of troll that's easy for everybody to make? Let's how about a can? Cut the can and maybe carve eyes out of it and little whiskers or something. I don't know. I want something where anybody can grab an item and make a face or something of their troll on their channel. If whatever they think. And you know that woman carved me! I said that thing looks like me! But I was happy. Oh, and that bag of hot air you gave me? I don't know. I think you're saying I had a bag of, I'm full of hot air. Which I am. See, at work, I tell everybody I'm a non-professional. I'm skipping. I do that with my disorder. A non-professional doing professional work. Because if you go around claiming you're professional, you're going to get thumbs down. So don't do that to yourself. There's a couple of people out there do that. Don't do that to yourself. Put yourself in the round table, not the square table.
Really?
Yep. If you're at the round table like the knights were, everybody's equal. If you put yourself in the corner, that means you're powerful and you know everything.
All I used to say, to be honest about that, is if you put yourself in the center of the campfire, you don't do nothing but burn yourself up.
Basically. All right. I think this is well done. My rambling's almost over. I hope you enjoy that rambling. Just talking about general things in YouTube that can maybe help other YouTubers. If you get a troll, do not, I'm telling you, do not feed that troll. Don't answer it in a negative, I got a troll. And what I say, thank you for the comment and gave him a thumbs up. And that scares trolls. They're like, oh yeah, he's gonna say something, and we'll say something back. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have fun with this son of a bitch. He's stupid, he's dumb, he's low. Then thank you for the share. Thank you for the comment. And they're like, what to do? It's like this. Next time you get a phone call, say what? And watch what happens on the other end. Instead of saying hello, say what? And watch the other side be like, try it next time when somebody calls and leave a video and post it on my link or his, or just tell me you got one and I'll go check it out. I want to hear what happened when your phone call. Instead of saying hello, say what? Or speak. And watch the other end and be like dumb. Like, I don't know what to say now. So if you feed a troll, the troll won't know what to say. Give it a positive, not a negative. Always go to the positive, never to the negative. If you go to negative, guess what? More negative. And guess what? Other negatives will come into that negative and make more negative. If you come to a plus, it almost kills it. It kills the negative. That's why we always have plus and negative, day and night. You got to have the opposite. And if you got the opposite from the other, it always goes in a circuit, like a battery. You can't put two pluses together, it won't work. You can't put two negatives together, it won't work. But if you take it and flip it like a magnet, you can also flip a magnet, north and south, or whatever how it goes. You put it together, it snaps. Turn it, poof, flies away. So always put a positive to any negative attitude towards anything. Anywheres, always go with the positive, never the negative. You might have haters because you got to the positive, but you'd be less negative and more positive because other people will be a positive with you. So if you do a positive, everybody will agree with you. Oh yeah, you're right there, you're right. You go negative, oh you're stupid, you're dumb, you're an idiot, you're retarded. That's what basically I hear from other YouTubers like Mr. Rapacion. I used to be a sub for him on my other channel, and he talks about his trolls, and I learn from other YouTubers. That's what bloggers about. Watch a couple blogs about different negatives and positives. So just always go to the positive of anybody, any troll, and you'll have a better life. Because every time you do negative, guess what? You're a negative person yourself. So you're never gonna be smiley, happy. And look at me. See how mad I got just talking about negative stuff? That's why I don't do drama. All right, what are we supposed to be doing, Mr. Manland?
You gotta set that aside and get ready to fix the bowl. Show them the final result.
Should we shift the thing in the taters, or we're gonna put it together or side to side?
We'll just sit them side by side.
All right, let's move this over here. I hope you enjoy my rambling about YouTubes and positive and negative, because you might learn from me in this video. You might not learn nothing from me in this video. But always make sure you go to a positive, never a negative. Do not feed your trolls.
Free bird!
All right, we got two bowls, two spoons, two healthy meals, and two drinks. Now, this is the fun part.
Right there. That's mine. Yeah.
It looks like
cold.
My girlfriend used to watch me cook, and I'll cook some weird shit. He says, "It don't go together. That looks like crap. Taste it. Taste it. Oh my God, I want more. I kill you. I kill Grandma for more." That's the basically what I get. All right, you want this on top?
Right. Perfecto.
All right, put this on the side, covered from the bugs. Now we got two bushcraft meals. I don't know how much fuel it might use. Okay.
I like a little bit of pepper.
You like a little bit of pepper?
And no salt.
No salt, I like no salt too. I like pepper too. All right, I'm Ranger Cookie.
He likes pepper.
Yeah, if you mix it all up with this one.
Absolutely.
Alright, I'm Ranger Cookie. This is Manland. I'm over here visiting his channel. I hope I see y'all next video. Ask any questions and I'll be happy to answer any type of way I can. Alright, I'll see y'all next video. More. Oh, I'm not taking a bite in it. Burn my mouth.